In this video, we will discuss the continuity equation for ideal fluids. First off, what exactly is an ideal fluid? An ideal fluid has no internal friction, which is measured by its viscosity. It also has a constant density, which means it is incompressible. We also want the fluid velocity to be constant at every point. So if we focus on one particular XYZ coordinate inside the fluid, the velocity vector should be constant. The velocities at different points can of course be different. Furthermore, there is no angular momentum carried by the fluid, so if you start with an object in a certain orientation, the object will perform a translation but no rotation. These lines here are called streamlines, by the way, which represent another condition for an ideal fluid, laminar flow. In other words, there is no turbulence in an ideal fluid. Now let's investigate the continuity equation. This equation can be derived from the principle of conservation of mass. Imagine a tube which is narrow at first, but then becomes wider towards the right. If we assume a constant flow, then a certain volume of fluid with mass m1 flowing in must lead to a certain volume of fluid with mass m2 flowing out. By assuming conservation of mass, we can say that m1 per time delta t is the same as m2 per delta t. Mass is density times volume, and since an ideal fluid has constant density everywhere, we can cancel rho on both sides. Next, we can write the volume as cross-sectional area A times the horizontal length delta x. And if we consider infinitesimally small time steps, then the fraction becomes a derivative and we get the continuity equation, where V stands for the fluid velocity. The physical interpretation of the continuity equation is quite simple. It tells us that if the cross-sectional area in the tube increases, the fluid velocity will decrease. And if the cross-sectional area decreases, the fluid velocity will increase. And that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching.